In the macroscopic world, the motion of an object is deterministic. The fact that this ball is immersed in the atmosphere is irrelevant in determining its trajectory at short distances. However, if this ball was a trillion times smaller, smaller than a cell, then its trajectory would become stochastic due to the collisions with the surrounding air molecules. This stochastic behavior is the realm of random walks. The goal of this tutorial is to outline some elementary, fundamental, and beautiful properties of random walks.
I'll begin by showing some examples of random walks in nature to highlight their ubiquity and their importance in a wide range of phenomena. Then I'll turn to a quantitative discussion of basic properties of random walks. I'll first show that the root mean square displacement of a random walk grows as the square root of the elapsed time. Next, I'll discuss the crucial role of the spatial dimension on the fundamental question of whether or not a random walk eventually returns to its starting point. A major portion of this tutorial is devoted to determining the underlying probability distribution of a random walk. I'll also show how one recovers the diffusion equation as the continuum limit of the evolution equation for the probability distribution function. A striking feature of a random walk is that its probability distribution at long times is independent of almost all microscopic details. This universality is embodied by the central limit theorem, which I'll also present. I'll also discuss the anomalous features that arise when the very mild conditions that underlie the central limit theorem are not satisfied. Finally, I'll present some basic first passage properties of random walks and finish by presenting a number of elementary and important applications.